Hey folks, it's Jang here with the Tracker 1, a non-canonical yet official LEGO Star Wars set from the Freemaker Adventures. I have to admit, my first impression of this thing is overall very positive. I believe it is ultimately derived from design concepts that eventually turned into Kylo Ren's command shuttle. I know it looks quite very different from Kylo Ren's command shuttle, but along the way to creating that design, there was something very similar to this, just with a TIE fighter style cockpit in the center. I think that's where LEGO took their inspiration from, just my hunch from what I'm seeing here. It looks pretty much the same no matter how you rotate it around. I actually think it looks better like this, if you have one of the wings facing straight down. There's something very very aggressive about that, very scary, like a three-bladed dagger or something. Wings are a little bit reminiscent of the TIE Striker in a way. You know, it definitely pulls from a lot of things from Star Wars and sci-fi in general, and I like it for all that, for all those reasons. The engines are built into the rears of the wings. That's nice to see. You can get the trans red that's in there. They make a nice use of these Nexo power combo plates, which is great to see. I got a bunch of those myself to use for something. It's the first place I've actually seen them used structurally. There's another one up here at the front of the thing. They try to make it look the same on the tops of wings and on the bottoms of wings. It's rare that you see LEGO do that, really put effort into designs on anti-stud sides of things. But they definitely did that here, and I think they did about as good as they could without having lots of different shapes of inverted tiles. So that's a respectable effort. Yeah. The one thing that I don't like here is that it doesn't sit on the ground very well if it's just in this kind of mode, in the horizontal mode. And I completely understand why that is. You know, it's not intended to be sat on the ground like this. It's intended to land vertically like that. That's how it lands. So that's how they expect you to store it. But I just think it looks so cool like this, though. I want to see it like this. So I'll have to make a custom stand for it or something. But yeah, it's supposed to land like this. Now check this out. It has three doors, one on each side. There's a small latch up at the top that's supposed to help hold them in place. And that right there is a ladder to get up to the cockpit. That's one thing that you see here. There's also a knob there, like a gear that appears to be used for turning something. Well, indeed it does turn something. That's intentional. Here's another one of those doors. I'll open up the latch properly this time. This one comes down and gives you access to a small jail cell over on this side. So these are bars that come down, and the idea is that you would put a minifigure there, like for instance Rowan, and then you would bring the bars up and close this up and take off with him. The thing on the other side, the gear that you can turn, helps to pop that figure out because it's a really tight squeeze to fit a person in there at all, and even with just a short figure like that. So this just has a very small mechanism that has a little lever that will push the figure out, just physically force them out, and they just kind of fall forward. Just makes it easy for you to remove them. But there is a third side to this over here. I'll open the latch, bring down the third door from here, and that just has a couple of clips inside there to hold on to a couple of lightsaber blades or blasters. Returning to the first side with the first door that I opened, that's where your pilot is supposed to go up inside. However, us huge figures have huge hands, and we can't actually make figures go through such a small space. It doesn't help that there are parts inside of there blocking you as well, but they gave us a cheat. They allow us to access the cockpit from the outside, and this is an interesting thing. We'll take a look at the pilot figure, you know, closely in a minute, but he has a clip on the back of him, which is going to be used to clip onto that set of bars there right in the center, and then he's going to flip up. Let me see if I can give you a good view of that. His clip comes in. I'm going to push that directly onto that bar. Kind of have to do it a little bit blind unless you're looking from the other side, but up he flips, like so. So now you're looking at the undersides of his legs, and the canopy just closes up right beneath. orienting the ship in its normal flight mode and looking at it from the side rather than the underside. There's the pilot in his cockpit. You can remove or open up one of these canopies to see him more clearly. And he has a couple of printed console pieces that are coming in diagonally from the sides, kind of from above. It's a nice use of that, bringing it in. Doesn't have quite a screen directly in front of him, but it's nice to have those kind of surrounding him. And he also has a backup blaster that's held right near him. On the other side, he has a pair of handcuffs. The main pilot figure is the MOC Hunter Droid. MOC, yep, like mock. It's that straightforward of a pun. He looks pretty cool though. Kind of like a cyborg version of the fifth brother from Rebels. Maybe crossed a little bit with the main sidekick robot from Buck Rogers in the 25th century. Two lightsabers for this guy with black hilts and reused mold for the shoulder and neck upper body armor, but a new one for the head itself. Yeah, I like it. It's different. I also like the use of the gunmetal gray base color for him. And he has a pretty snazzy looking series of prints as well, including print on the hip piece there. And it's well printed across the back as well. Here's Rowan Freemaker and comic relief Emperor Palpatine, the best Emperor Palpatine of all. With a couple of bolts of Sith lightning there, looks like he's gonna try to get serious, but I have a feeling he's probably not gonna use that lightning against anything, you know, that we're really gonna worry about too much, because like I said, it is comic relief Palpatine. No alternate, well, no print on the back of the torso for that, but there is at least an alternate face for him because it is just the standard version of him. Too bad there's no alternate face for Rowan though. However, at least Rowan does get an alternate set of headgear. He gets his pilot's helmet with goggles, so just a couple options there, and of course those can be brought down. And if you feel like it, they can even be kind of centered. The very last thing to look at is a medium-small build of an Imperial probe droid. And these fit in well to anything in the original trilogy era, so it's nice to get another one, I think. So that's the Tracker 1. It's another set that I think looks pretty cool and is pretty well done, but that I feel probably won't sell very well unless this second season of Freemaker Adventures, from which this derives, is really fantastic. I mean, the first season I thought was good. I thought it was funny, it was enjoyable, told a story that was, you know, good to follow along with, but actually liked the Star Scavenger out of that, but they made a really terrible Star Scavenger model. This, I think, is a good model, but it doesn't seem to bring all that much to Star Wars fans in general. Interesting figure right there. This is cool, that's cool, but I don't see this really, you know, sticking with fans that strongly or making that great of an impression. One thing that I did forget to acknowledge is that the blue lines in here are a reference to the original LEGO Star Wars models for TIE fighters and such, where they brought in blue as an accent so they wouldn't be too boring looking, and they would bring in just a little bit of the actual blue from the real things in universe. Thank you for tuning in to this review. If there's anything you would like to say about the set, feel free to leave a comment down below, and I'll talk to you again soon in my next video. Bye for now.